will learn of how flowers attract insects like bees and butterflies for pollination. Bees and other insects use their vision or eyesight to locate nectar sources. Because of this, flowers use vibrant colors to attract insects. These bright colors act as a target, guiding insects to exactly where the flower's nectar is. Because these bright colors act as a target, they must stick out from the rest of the flower, which is why we don't see many green flowers. Green would blend in with the leaves of the flower, making them difficult to locate and confusing the potential pollinators. In fact, many insects, like bees, see in a special spectrum called the ultraviolet spectrum. The ultraviolet spectrum is not visible to humans. However, if we placed a flower under a black light, we would see something similar to what many insects see when they look at a flower. Because pollinators, or insects, see in a different spectrum than we do, they can see special patterns that we cannot. Flowers often even display a bullseye pattern, further guiding pollinators to the right area. We will need 4 volunteers from the class. 2 of the 4 volunteers will be flower holders, who will hold the flower by the stem and wave it gently as if it were swaying in the breeze. As the flowers wave in the wind, it can make it difficult for bees to get down to the nectar. The other 2 students will be the pollinators. The pollinators will put a coffee straw in their mouth and hold their hands behind their back. The pollinators will also get to wear these special dealy bobbers, making them into the perfect insects. Each pollinator will be assigned to a different flower. Make sure the flower tube is visible to the rest of the class. On the count of 3, each insect will try to get their straw down into the nectar tube of the flower as it waves in the breeze. The insects will stick a coffee straw down into the nectar tube of the flower and try to suck up one of the red pom-poms in the bottom of the flower. The nectar is represented by the red pom-poms in the bottom of the tube. The goal is to drive one of the red pom-poms up to the top of the flower towards the head of the flower. You do not need to take the pom-pom out, just simply bring it to the top. Repeat this activity with several other insect volunteers. Your teacher will make a table showing which flower was the winner in each case. Was there a flower that won more times than the other flower? In other words, was there a flower that pollinators were more successful at getting nectar out of than the other flower? Are there any differences between these 2 flowers? Discuss this with your classmates. I hope you enjoy learning about pollination and how bright colors help flowers attract potential pollinators.